Hello students, in this video we'll learn 8255 mode 1 strobe input data transfer through waveforms timing diagram. In the last video we have seen how the interrupt signals are generated using port C signals as strobe signals. In mode 1, port A, PC5 and PC4 are used, and in mode 1, port P, PC1 and PC2 are used for enabling INTR interrupt request to the microprocessor. The same is indicated using the timing diagram. Now, strobe signal is used to indicate that a data is present on IO lines of port A or port B. Once the data is present on port lines, then the input buffer full indicates a high. When it indicates a high, actually STB is active low, that's why it has shown as a low. When STB is active low, this handshake signal is enabled. When it is enabled, then the input buffer goes full. When it goes full, then through these two input signals and through the AND gate, an interrupt request signal is generated, and this interrupt signal is active high. Then this interrupt signal is given to microprocessor for requesting that an IO device needs its services. Now once its request has been accepted by the microprocessor releases a signal called as read. Again, read is active low. When read goes active low, at that moment the INTR interrupt request goes disable, it goes low. Now when it goes low, it clears the interrupt request for another device, then the read signal performs the read operation. Now when the read signal goes high, at that moment whatever the data which is present in the buffer has now read by the microprocessor, therefore it goes low. Now at this case, whatever the data which is available on the data bus is read by the microprocessor from an external device.